Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining in. It's a very cloudy day here in Granada, Spain. Luckily, we're inside of the finals hall, ready for the first senior competition of the ISSF World Cup here in Granada, Spain 2024. My name is Martina Lucic, and I will be your commentator for the next few days of these finals. We have exciting 3 days ahead, 10-meter pistol, mixed team air rifle and air pistol, and finally the 10-meter rifle events. First one on the schedule is the 10-meter air pistol men event, where they're breaking the ice of the senior competition. Some big names were in qualification. 58 athletes approached the qualification line this morning to shoot their 60 shots and try to end up in the top 8 to join us here in the final hall. All the competition schedule and results are up on the ISSF web. You can also find it on the ISSF Instagram page, and we are broadcasting live on YouTube and Facebook. The juniors had their events in the first few days of competition. The winners are up online if you want to check the upcoming youth of this sport. But anyway, you know the drill. I'm sure the athletes will be shooting 2 series of 5 shots before switching to single shots and the elimination process for the lowest ranking finalists in that moment after every 2 shot begins. Preparation and sighting shots will start now. These are the qualification scores. It was pretty hard to get in today. We have Slovakia, Turkey, Italy, Latvia, Switzerland, Germany, and Bulgaria. Here we are with the seniors. It's a big year for these guys as the Olympics are right around the corner, counting 161 days exact until the start of this grand competition. Let's meet the athletes. 24-year-old Robin Walter from Germany is going to be shooting on point A. He won the gold at the last World Cup final that was in Doha last year. Here is his coach. Walter was sixth after qualification. Then on firing point B, we have 25-year-old who was in the finals in Cairo at the last World Cup. That was in January. He finished fifth. We'll see how it goes for him today. He was third after qualification with a good score of 585. Here's Jason Solari, the 24-year-old from Buenos Aires 2018 Youth Olympic Games, where he won a bronze medal. This is his second final at the World Cup. He was actually fourth in World Cup Bhopal last year when Sarab Jot Singh won the World Cup, shooting the last shot a 10.9. Sarab Jot was 10th today in qualification, almost got in the finals, but we're not going to be watching him today, at least this time. So you can tell that the competition was pretty strong in this ISSF World Cup. Second for rifle and pistol of this year. Federico Nilo Maldini, the 22-year-old from Italy, has won the Rio World Cup last year, his only individual medal, and his only gold medal as well. He's got additional 3 medals from World Cups, team and mixed team events, but this is his only individual one. Juraj Tuzinski of Slovakia, he was fourth at the Rio Olympics. 10 years ago here, he made his highest ranking at the World Championship here in Granada. That was 2014, and he was seventh. But he has won 2 World Cups in the last 2 years, one in Cairo last year and in Rio 2 years ago. Now this is Samuel Donkov maybe taking the momentum, the 40-year-old. And the last World Cup, that was in Cairo, just weeks before this one, he won a silver medal. Before that, his last medal was in 2018 in Changwon World Cup. Here's his coach, Mr. Boris. Joining Samuel Idonkov, another medalist from Cairo, Lauris Strausmanis, 28-year-old, who won the bronze medal in Cairo. And he also has a bronze medal from, he's also won a bronze medal in Rio last year. So these two are back at it, actually, once again in the finals together. And we will see if they find themselves on the podium once again. Who knows? Bura Selimzadeh, 35-year-old, yet to win an individual World Cup medal. He does have a team gold from Jakarta last year. And this is not his first final at the World Cup. He was 7th in Baku 2 years ago and 8th in Lima's World Cup last year. So he has some experience with the finals. We'll see how he finds himself amongst these big names in the finals. Just a few more seconds are left before we start with the first series of five. As I mentioned, there's going to be two series of five before we begin. But first of all, of course, we've met them, but now it's time for the audience here in the final hall to meet the athletes once again. Let's see their faces now as they're not shooting. And yeah, this is when everything, the energy shifts in the room and things start to get a bit more serious when it's not sighting time anymore. Here's a close-up on Robin Walter, the 24-year-old. He's got two World Cup medals from last 2 years. Those are the only two individual medals he's won, a silver medal in Rio in 2022 and a bronze medal in Baku in 2023. Now, this is a familiar face. The 25-year-old Paolo Mona has been finding himself more and more in the finals. He's won a silver medal in Cairo last year. He was so close to gold. It was a hard final for the young pistol athlete. Since then, we've seen him in the finals a couple of times. He was in the last Cairo 2024 World Cup as well. Fifth, Jason Solari. Almost on the podium in Bhopal. You can see the atmosphere in the room. It's a big final hall. A lot of places to have the audience. Federico Nilo Maldini. Once again. He's the youngest of the eight here. But as you know, in this sport, that might not mean anything. Juraj Cieszyński. He's won a bronze medal two times at World Cups back in 2015 and 2016, only to come back and win two World Cups in the last 2 years. Cairo in 23. And Rio in 22. Samuel Donkov, Bulgarian athlete of 40 years old. We'll see if that's his World Cup once again, just like Lauris Strausmanis, the 28-year-old. He's finding himself in the second final of a World Cup. in this year. And, oh, that's some good stats, isn't it? Bora Selimzade, the 35-year-old, opting for his first individual World Cup medal. So we get our eight athletes competing in the 10-meter air pistol men's event. Let me tell you, the jury member in charge of this final is Mr. Antonio Canizares of Spain. Of course, it's time for the officials as well. Both of the juries are from Spain. It's always nice to have the locals showing up for the main positions in the finals. One more minute until the first shot in the finals. There's an interesting thing about Lauris Trasmanis, the 28-year-old. Here in Granada, 10 years ago, he won his first World Championship medal. When he was still a junior, he won a bronze medal, and that was in 2014. So this might be a lucky finals haul for him. Definitely stayed in his memory, I'm sure, in a very, very nice way. Here we have it, the world record of this discipline. And as I already mentioned, this is a big year for these athletes as the Olympics are coming and many quotas have been awarded to the nations already. Some have their own kind of internal system to decide who gets in. So we're still going to have to wait to find out who will be at the Olympics and participating in Paris, more accurately, Châteauroux, this year. But let's focus on what's right in front of us. That is the ISSF World Cup for 10 meters in for rifle and pistol in Granada, Spain, 2024. We're ready to start. This is Palomona. He hasn't fired a shot yet. Let's see, he's taking another try. Ah, Donkov doesn't seem too pleased with the 9.5. Walter started with an 8.7, but is getting closer to the circle of 10 with a 9.5. Looks like it's going good for Salimzade. He has taken the lead. Mona and Walter at the bottom. I had a nice start, but then there was that 8. It kind of pushed him down the rank again. Salimzade. We had 2 tens so far. And another very, very close one. Maldini took over the lead. Usually these two series of five are kind of a moment for the athletes to establish themselves in the finals right before, you know, the elimination process starts. And hands start trembling even more. But this is a pretty good time to get ahead as much as possible, which is something Maldini and Selimzadeh Tuzinski as well managed to do pretty well so far. I think we might be used to seeing even higher scores, but it is only the first round of five. Things are still pretty tense. And I have to say, they're going to get even more tenseful. And with that last shot, that's it.
So this final is up and running after the
first series of five is finished. Tuzinski has taken the lead. 0.2 of a difference. Look at that. It's going to be a tied final. Only 0.2 of a difference between the first and the second place. Then it's completely tied. Maldini and Solari. Then Selimzadeh is right behind. 0.2 of a difference. Showing us that this whole thing might change pretty heavily during the finals. It's definitely not showing that this might stay this way. Usually when the finals are so close, when the scores are so close, we see many, many turnovers. Another series of five is ahead, though. So stay put. Let's see what happens. Paolo Mona shot this one. He didn't look too happy about it. Had a kind of a reaction to the shot. It was a 9.6. Nice stats we have over here. Two World Cup golds that I mentioned for Jure Tuzinski. One in Cairo in 23 and in Rio 22. And the two bronze medals he has from back almost 10 years ago. So he's been in the game for quite some time. And we can still find him at the top. Let's see his next shot after a 9.7. Will he find the center of the target? And he does, a 10.3 for Tuzinski. He's currently holding the second position. He's one of the proper seniors here in the game. He's been at it for a long time, the 39-year-old. Solari's doing pretty good as well. Here is Selimzadeh. Cannot forget about the Turkish athlete. He's one of the athletes who has the least experience maybe today. But he's fighting himself pretty well in this final. Palomona. He's got a couple of World Cup golds from team and mixed team events. But his only individual two medals are a bronze from Changwon in 22 and a silver from Cairo. That was a pretty strong battle when he won that silver. Looks like he's not too happy with this round, but he did wrap up with a 10.7. He is pretty low on the rank, though. Let's see Robin Walter. His last shot is a 9.7. We've seen some pretty nice shots, but most of them were nines, some even slim nines. Eight here and there as well. Really always depends on the competition. Sometimes the energy of the room is bringing great results, and sometimes they don't go as high as we expect.
Stop. Series two, over and out. And we have a new leader in this final. It is Jason.
Let's see how things have changed. And Solari took the lead now. Look at the differences. They have gone up. 0.9 of a difference between Solari and Maldini, then 0.6 of a difference between him and Salimzadeh. That's a whole point of a difference between the first and the fourth ranking athlete. And then you see a big break over there between fifth and the sixth place, 2.5, which means that might be a bit of a hard difference to overcome there. We're moving into the single shots. I think the audience is very aware as the energy is shifting. 50 seconds on the clock for each of the single shots. And after each two, one of the athletes goes out. I have to say, not the strongest of results that we would think to have. Tuzinski had a nice one, 10.5, but everyone else went more or less out of the 10. Strassmanis had a bit of a slim one as well. In the red zone, down there at the bottom of the rank. Last World Cups silver medalist just weeks ago. At the bottom of the rank, there with Mona as well. Pretty close. 0.6 of a difference. There is still some hope for the Bulgarian. But this might be his last shot. Let's see. Oh, wow. Nice shot from Strassmanis. Mona's not happy. 8.9 is not going to cut it. And that's going to plummet him down to a slim difference of 0.1. So there was hope for the Bulgarian, and looks like things got too tense full for the 25-year-old from Italy. He's going to be leaving, winning the eighth place in Cairo. He was fifth. Looks like he might have wanted it a bit too hard, and the tension got to him. Eighth place to Palomona. And now Donkov finds himself in a bit of a pickle. Once again, 2.2 of a difference is not an easy difference to overcome in a, even in the pistol final, let alone the rifle one. But here we are doing the pistol. Strassmanis is at the top of the rank, and I'm not surprised with that last really great 10. Where he would find himself, and he has continued on. Looks like he's going to be keeping the lead for now. Everybody wrapped up this single shot, and I would say we are seeing some better results now. 10.5 is over there. Those are pretty good shots, pretty stable 10s. But in the pistol, competition, even a 10.2, a 10.3 would be great. An 8 really might be a bit of a mishap, but a nice strong 9 could still be called a good shot as well. Duncan finds himself in the red zone once again. The differences are getting higher at the bottom there. 0.9 and 3 points between Walter and Salimzadeh. Donkov shot a 9.2. Oh, Saladi went into an 8. It's going to push him down the rank. But first, the decision of the 7th place last World Cup silver medalist wins the 7th place at the ISSF World Cup. 10-meter rifle and pistol here in Granada. Very well done. 2 World Cups this year so far. 2 finals for Samuel Donkov. Not a bad beginning of the Olympic year. There's been a change at the top. Tuzinski took over. Strauss-Manis is right behind. Slim difference between the first 2 finalists, 2 ranked athletes, which means might see some more changes at the top. Robin Walter. He wrapped up last year pretty well, winning the gold at the World Cup final in Doha. It's a big difference between him and Solari. 9.6 might not cut it. But there is still one more shot to shoot. Now even the bigger difference, which means I'm not sure I even can call it red zone anymore. It's a danger zone right now for Walter. The decision of the 6th place is ahead. Robin is getting some words of encouragement from the audience. I can't really speak German, but it did sound like a positive thing. Hopefully it's going to work well for him, but it still is a big difference. Oh, Solari out into an 8, giving potentially, but not enough of an opportunity for Robin Walter. And the 24-year-old Baku's bronze medalist from 2023 wins the 6th place. Leaving Solari, Selimzadeh, Maldini, Tuzinski, and Strauss-Manis at the top. Again, another switch between Strauss-Manis and Tuzinski, and it looks like 0.2 of a difference is kind of their thing in this final. For the next competition shot, no. Start. 50 seconds on the clock for the next one. The next 2 should potentially decide on the 5th place. Oh, nicely done. 10.9 from Strauss-Manis. He's been showing up. Tuzinski is right there with a 10.5. But now, a nice difference for Strauss-Manis at the top. 0.6 between him and Tuzinski. The The scores are getting a bit better, but you can see where Stavs Manis has been for at least the last 10 shots, and he is way up there. Very nice scores, very stable shooting. Here and there, a strong 9, but other than that, he's been in the 10 circle for most of the time, so no wonder he is at the top of the rank. Switzerland's Jason Salati. He's been up and down, and he's in danger zone right now. And he hasn't helped himself out with the 8.4. The fifth place, looks like it goes to Jason Salati, the Swiss athlete, 24-year-old, who was very successful back in 2018 in Buenos Aires at the Youth Olympic Games. It's always great for the youth to have that kind of competitions to kind of prepare them for the seniors ones. We have Stavs Manis at the top now, a comfortable difference of 1.3 between him and Tuzinski, then Maldini and Samzadeh, 35-year-old, who is opting for his first individual, his first World Cup medal. 0.3 of a difference only. Might happen. Maldini, 9.3. Stavs Manis still in the center of the target, holding the lead. And if you remember from the beginning, he was here in Granada 10 years ago where he won his first world championship medal. It was a bronze medal, and he was still a junior back then in 2014. He's also a bronze medalist of the last World Cup, the first one of this year. That was in Cairo. And now he's finding himself at the top of the rank in the second World Cup of the Olympic year. So pretty impressive for the 28-year-old. Oh, out into an 8.6. Looks like nerves got to the 28-year-old. He is still safe, though, and still at the top. That's why it's always good to have a good, comfortable difference. But the fourth place will go to Federico Nilo Maldini, 22 Italian athlete. 22 years old, so he is and was the youngest of the eight in the finals. He's got a long career ahead, and looks like it's a great day for Salimzadeh. This is going to be his first individual World Cup medal. We yet don't know the shine of the medal, but we definitely know he is in the top three, which means he will end up on the podium. The difference is a bit high, but Stavs Manis and Tuzinski are back at the 0.2 that they were at a few times already in this final, I think. They're definitely making it interesting. Salimzadeh had a 10.7 in the last round. Kept himself safe throughout now. Let's see if he is able to get even more ahead. But Tuzinski is 10.7 from the 39-year-old. Climbs up to the top of the rank. Leaves Stavs Manis behind. 0.7 of a difference. Next shot if there is no shoot-off, of course, is to decide the bronze medal. Stasmanis has 2 World Cup medals, and only in the last year, and both of them are bronze medals. So I guess he's opting for something more this time. So Mzade, he shoots a 10.0. Sanzade 9.7, and this is going to keep Strauss-Manis safe for now. But the Turkish athlete, for the first time in his career, Buret Selimzade wins an individual World Cup medal. The 35-year-old came in. He had a great qualification score, 585. He was second after the qualification, and he held his ground firmly and won the bronze. We're going to find him at the podium. But first, the decision for the gold medal. Tuzinski and Strauss-Manis, 0.5 of a difference and 2 shots. 9.5. And a 10.6 from Tuzinski is not giving in. The Rio Olympics 4th place athlete. It was so close to the podium. Start. 1.6, if I'm not mistaken, is the difference. That's pretty high difference, but you never know. Strauss-Manis 10.4. He did everything he could, but Tuzinski is not giving in. A 10.6 makes the Slovakian athlete winning his 3rd World Cup in the last 2 years. Cairo, Rio, and now Granada is on his list of gold medals. And the Latvian Lauris Strauss-Manis finally with the silver medal after 2 bronze medals at the World Cup. Everybody had a breakthrough today, I would say, with Buret Selimzade winning his 1st one. We'll try to have a quick conversation with the winners, so stay with us. But these are the winning athletes of the first ISSF World Cup senior final here in Granada 2024. Buret Selimzade with the bronze, Lauris Strauss-Manis with the silver, and Juraj Tuzinski with the gold.
Once again to our medalists and all to say.
All right, we're here with the silver medalist, Laudis. How are you feeling? This is your first silver one. You've had two bronze medals at the World Cup already. Were you opting for that, going higher than the bronze?
I'm feeling pretty good, but not because of the bronze, but because of the great result and because of the great achievement. Last time I was here 10 years ago in 2014, and it was I was a junior. I was 18 years old, and we had a gold medal, and individually I had a bronze medal in World Championship. Yeah, and next time I'm here, I'm getting a medal again, so it feels very good. It feels really nice, but now as an adult.
So it's a good final hole for you. You started this year, two finals in the World Cups, two World Cups that we even had so far, two medals. How are you feeling about that?
I'm feeling lucky. Okay. Luck is very... very good, but you know, I've been working home very hard, and we've been competing. So we've been competing with each other in Latvia to get the best out of us. But I know, well, if you put in some work, and then it comes out sooner or later.
Well, congratulations again, and now I'm pretty sure I'm going to see you in the next one. So see you again.
I really hope so. Thank you very much. Thank you.
That's it for our finalists. We're going to go into the second final of the day at 4 o'clock. Come back. It's going to be the women's finals.